Today I'm going to show you how to create this simple abstract scene in Blender. Now we're going to be using Eevee as the rendering engine for this, and this tutorial is very simple, very easy to make, and we can probably get it done here in a couple minutes. So I'll show you the finished file here in Eevee. It's just a simple landscape, but we're using the wireframe add-on, and then we are applying the emission shader and an ocean just with a little bit of roughness with a basic glossy shader to get you this really cool result. So let's jump right into it. Okay, so with Blender loaded up, let's go ahead and get started by deleting the default cube, and we're going to replace that with the landscape. Now, if you don't see this add-on enabled, go ahead and head over to Edit, Preferences, and in the search bar, just start typing in landscape, and it's going to be this guy right here, Add Mesh, ANT Landscape. All right, so here in the toolbar settings, we've got a list of different options to choose from. We're going to stay pretty basic with stuff that is very easy to understand. So a little trick here to go through all these types pretty quickly, just hit Control and with your mouse wheel, just scroll up and down and you can very easily go through the different options. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, so you can get any kind of landscape that you want. There's a wide range of different options to choose from. So I'll just find one that looks pretty cool. Let's see here. You can definitely have a lot of different options to choose from. You get like weird sci-fi mountains. It's pretty fun. I spent a while playing around with the different types. But we'll go with something like that. Looks kind of interesting. Okay. So we're not going to really touch much of these settings. We'll change the depth here to be about 12. That just gives it a little more depth, but it kind of tightens up the vertices a little bit more, kind of smooths it out just a little bit. It's a very, very slight effect. But all we're going to do here is the subdivisions here. So on the X and Y, it's best if they match. So we'll do 512 by 512. And that's just gonna give us a higher detail landscape to work with. Okay, awesome. So let's go ahead and scale that up just a little bit here. Awesome, all right. Let's go ahead and add in a plane and we'll add in the modifier, ocean modifier, okay. Now we're gonna scale this down so I get some smaller waves. Okay, so scale that way down to about like a 12 or so, okay? Let me get more room here for us. Okay, now we're going to increase that by 3 by 3 along the X and the Y. So when you turn down the spatial size, your waves get a little smaller, so it helps with the scaling size of the landscape. Just a little tip there for you. We'll go ahead and turn down the scale of this to be something pretty low, about 0.08. And as well as that, we're going to increase the res here to about 20. So we get lots of detail to work with. Okay, let's push the ocean into the middle of the scene. And let's also rotate our landscape along the Z axis to something a little more interesting. And we'll kind of put that in the water a little more. This is also how you might make an island with cycles or Eevee. This is the same type of effect, but we're going for more of an abstract type rendering here. Okay, so in the modifier panel, let's go ahead and select wireframe. This is what gives you the very cool effect. Now be warned, your computer's probably gonna slow down quite a bit because it's a lot of geometry that's being calculated. So just an FYI on that. Okay, so you can see it does weird stuff to the landscape. It is working, but the thickness, it's way too thick right now. So we're going to turn down that thickness to a 0.0005, like really small, okay? Something about there should be pretty good. Okay, now let's go ahead and set up our camera. So I'm going to come into front view, control alt number pad 0, snap the camera into view. All right, and let's get a cool shot like we had. I'm going to come all the way out here and then tighten up the frame a little bit, maybe about 80 millimeters. Come down a little bit more. Again, this is all personal preference. You can set this up however you want. It is your scene. Okay. I'm gonna come down a little bit more on the scale of the ocean water there. I don't want it too wavy. That's a little too much. Okay. So let's set up the materials. So I'm just gonna come in. Nice big view here for us. And let's go into rendered view. So this is what you should see right now in Eevee with rendered view. We just have our basic lamp and everything set up. So we're gonna go ahead and delete the lamp. And I'm gonna make the background completely black. Okay. Now we're gonna select the landscape and we're simply just gonna add in a new material. We're gonna change the type to emission. And we're gonna set that to about a 5. And I'm also gonna make it a little blue. Okay. And then quite simply, we add in a new material for the ocean, make that a glossy, and 0.01. So there's a little bit of roughness, but not too much roughness. Now, if you want more of a cinematic kind of feel to the scene, I have pre-selected Ultra HD TV at a 16:9 ratio, but if you want a 235, you can increase the resolution on here to get you that kind of effect. All right. And as well as that, we'll just add in a little bit of higher contrast. Now, how to get the glow and everything, that's simply done with Bloom. Bloom enables the glow. Ambient occlusion doesn't really matter in this. Screen space reflections is definitely a big one that you're going to want to check to get the reflections on the ocean material. But other than that, I'll increase the f-stop here on the depth of field a little bit more. It's a little too much, about 7 or so. Okay. And that's pretty much it, guys. That's the tutorial. It's a very simple abstract scene, but it's very fun to play with. You can make all kinds of landscapes. You can make any kind of character, any kind of object in a wireframe, and you can play around with it in Eevee in real time. So it's a really cool effect. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and go ahead and subscribe for more videos coming out here. And I can't wait to see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.